All right, good morning, YouTube. It is early, it's like 8 o'clock, something like that. My kids are up, and I am making Sunday breakfast, which is going to be bacon, egg, and cheese biscuits. And I don't think I ever made a video on how I make my biscuits, so I figured I would go ahead and share that with you guys. Let me get y'all focused here. So, really, really easy. You want to remember to have your butter cold, because that's the key. I'm going to go about my pastry cutter. If you have one of these, they are very, very useful. Turn on the light. All right, you don't need that, but it comes in handy. So. All right, so the first thing I want to do is I want to make my buttermilk, because I'm making buttermilk biscuits. And what I use is Seiko cultured buttermilk. It's powdered buttermilk. That way I don't have to have the liquid in my fridge and it won't go bad. You know, this is available to me anytime I want to fix it up. So you can get this at your grocery store. This is even available at Walmart. So easy, easy, easy to find. And then just read your directions on the back. Now we need 2 cups of buttermilk. You do not make this with milk, you make it with water. So I've got my 2 cups of water here. I keep it like room temperature. I don't make it cold, I don't make it warm. If you do it too cold, the buttermilk won't mix very well. And if you do it too warm, of course you're gonna melt your butter, which is, you know, not what you wanna do when you're making biscuits, because the butter is gonna help make it fluffy. So I just kind of keep it room temperature. And it says here, for 1 cup of buttermilk, you're going to use 4 tablespoons of buttermilk. So I need 8 tablespoons. And I just plop it right in. And I don't make it very... 4, 5, 6, 7... As you can see, I don't care if I'm very accurate or precise on this. I just want 8 tablespoons in there. A little more, a little less, it'll work. All right, and then I'm just gonna beat this up. And I do this first, that way it can stand and it can actually kind of become buttermilk while I'm making the rest of the mix. All right, so that is good. We're just gonna go ahead and set that aside. Now in my bowl, I am going to add, and of course I'm running out of battery, so hold on 1 second. I'll be right back. Let me go change the battery. Alrighty, fresh battery. Okay, so I'm gonna start with my dry ingredients. We're gonna start with 4 cups of all-purpose flour. And again, I don't have to be super precise. I kinda just scrape it on the side of the bowl to get my cup, all right. 1 and 4. Okay, and then to this we are going to add 2 tablespoons of baking powder. And this is my baking powder. I buy it in bulk because I use so much of it. yours might be a little smaller than mine. And we're gonna use 2 tablespoons. And what I do is when I pull it out, I just scrape it along the edge on the top, and it gives me a nice level tablespoon. So 1, 2. Then we're going to use some baking soda. They are different. And on this, we're going to use 1 teaspoon. Same thing. I just go in. I scrape it along the edge, the side, and it gives me a good level teaspoon. Okay, we're going to do 2 teaspoons of salt. And I keep my salt right here. I always wipe off my spoons as I go, just so I don't contaminate anything else. Dry ingredients, it's easy to do that. Okay, we're gonna do 2 teaspoons of sugar. My sugar bowl is behind me. Big old sugar bowl. You turn your back around this way. So 2 teaspoons of sugar. There we go. Okay. And then once I've got all those ingredients, let me aim you down a little bit so you can see a little better. Okay, once we have all those ingredients in the bowl, you can go ahead and use a spatula if you want. I just use my pastry cutter, and I just make sure that it's all nice and mixed. Okay, and once you have it mixed, we're going to add our butter to it. Bring over my cutting board, just a little cutting board, and I have a butter knife, and we have butter, and we are going to add 12 tablespoons to this, okay? So, I think we have, well, somebody took a little nudge off of that, so let's start with a whole 8 first. Okay. And the trick to making good buttermilk biscuits is you want to work the butter in, but you want it to stay cold. So use cold sticks. Don't take these out until right before you're going to make your biscuits. And what I do is I cut it longwise first. Okay. So I have 2 halves, and then I go ahead and I cut it one more time in half. So you're basically cutting these in fours or quarters, okay, and then really small pieces from there. This just makes it easier to work it into your flour. It really does. I'm gonna cut one more time. So, and you want to work fast because this stuff gets soft. So there's my little chunks. There's my bowl. I'm just gonna kinda toss these into the flour mixture. Okay. And then let's get 4 more tablespoons. I'm gonna take it from a half that hasn't been touched yet. Same thing, in half, in quarters. Tiny little pieces. Lop it in. Okay. Once you do that, go ahead and take your pastry cutter. What I like to do is I just like to make sure that these are all kind of coated in butter or in flour first. And then with your pastry cutter, you're just going to cut that butter right into the flour. Scrape the side there too. And you know when you're there, when you cut all the butter in, because the flour mixture will start to turn like grainy, almost like a cornmeal texture. Not quite, but very similar. Okay, you just don't want any chunks. That's why cutting it up in little pieces first just makes it easier to then kind of work it into your flour. Okay, now once you've got it all mixed in, make sure you take off any butter that might be left on your I will show you the texture. Do you see how it's a bit grainy? That's what you want. All right, so then what I do, I take a spatula, I make a little well in the center, okay, just a little hole, and then I pour my buttermilk. Okay, go ahead and pour my buttermilk in. I pour about half of it, then I'll mix. And what I like to do is I like to just pull the dry ingredients over onto it, because you definitely don't want to over mix your mixture here. It'll make for a tougher, flatter buttermilk biscuit. So I just lightly get this incorporated. Again, the key is don't overmix. Don't be too hard. Have a gentle hand. Okay. And then once I get it all, get some dry mix down there. Once I get it kind of all mixed up here, okay, and it's all moist, I'm going to take it over to my board. I'm going to move your camera, and you're going to join me on my cutting board.
All right,
so, once you're at your cutting board, I'm going to take some flour, okay, and I'm going to just cover my board. Don't need too much, but you want to make sure that your board is covered, because this stuff is going to be sticky. Okay, then we're going to take our mix out of our bowl. I'm going to try to get as much as I can out of here. And I'm just going to plop it right on to my flour here. Okay, take off as much as you can. This is a biscuit's worth. Waste not, want not. That is the saying. Okay, now once you get that out, you're going to sprinkle some flour right on top. Okay? This just makes it so the dough can be workable without sticking to your hand. Okay? And what I just like to do, I just like to fold it over a few times. Knead it a few times. And this is what, if you look, if you can see it, I'm hoping you can see it, you can start seeing how flaky it is already. So, okay, so the next step is then to roll it out some. Don't want to roll it out too flat. Can you grab me that big flat cookie sheet, please? Okay, because depending on how you roll it, it's going to depend on how big your biscuits are. So if you want flat biscuits, roll it out a lot. If you want thicker biscuits like I do, be careful with that.
Ah, thank you.
And then on a cookie sheet, we have a cookie sheet here. You're going to take a cookie biscuit cutter, and you're just going to use as much of the dough as you can. Okay, and there's your biscuit. You can already see. Now these, mine split on their own, so when you go to cut into them, they actually split on their own when you go and open them up to make a sandwich. So there you go. There's a biscuit.
Okay.
Easy peasy.
Not hard at all. It's basically just getting a feel for biscuit dough.
And
like I said, keeping your butter cold is key. Just like when you make a pie crust. That's what's going to give you the flaky biscuits. You see where mine's splitting already? Now when that's done cooking, it'll basically just pull apart in half. And you won't even have to cut it. Now, when I get to the end here, okay, where I can't really make any more biscuits without it being a funny, I actually might be able to cut one right there. Without it being too funny of a shape. Nah, look, it looks like somebody bit off it already. Okay, so what I do with my scrap, gently, because you don't want to overwork it, because the more you overwork it, the more of those layers you're going to lose, okay? So I just kind of blend it back into a ball gently, okay? And once again, I roll it out. Not too flat, because I like my biscuits thick and fluffy, like my men. And then go ahead and cut yourself another biscuit. And the more you make these, the easier it gets. I have to admit, the first couple times that I made biscuits, I think the first time I made them, I actually melted my butter in the microwave, not knowing I was supposed to use cold butter. So yeah, you learn, you live, you learn, you make your mistakes, you figure it out, and each time I make these now, I swear they get better and better. Okay, I should be able to get maybe two biscuits out of this. Okay, and I just want to show you, they're all pretty consistent. Maybe two biscuits. Okay. And then sometimes your last biscuit will be kind of ugly. Sometimes I'll get out the little small little cutter. I have a small little baby cutter right here. And this one's my Mason cutter. And sometimes I'll just make him a couple of little mini biscuits. He likes these with honey. So I'll make a couple of these little Mason-sized biscuits. And you could make them all mini. I mean, depending on your biscuit cutter, you know. I'm sure you could make shapes probably for Halloween and everything. Could be fun. I'm gonna make another little Mason biscuit. And I use all my biscuit dough. At least I try to. I mean, like I said, waste not, want not. And this is all food. And even if it's just a little smidgen like that, a little, what my husband calls biscuit poppers. And if you ever get to the point where your dough's a little sticky, just put a little bit, dab it a little bit in flour. And I don't think I really have to cut this one. So basically, if you have one left, you can just kind of eyeball it and shape it with your hand. Like so. Okay. This one's a little ugly, but that's all right. All right, so I'm just going to slide this over here real fast for you and show you my biscuits. Gonna straighten them up a little bit. Okay, now if you want to make them look a little fancy, you can take a little bit of your flour and you can lightly sprinkle the tops of them so they look all homemade. Yeah, I've learned the tricks. All right, so this one's a little splitty. That's all right. So that is it. So I'm gonna pop these into a 375 degree oven. I'm gonna take you over here. I'm gonna wash my hands. Grab my towel here. Okay, so let me just kinda bring you over to my counter over here. Now, I am making, like I said, bacon, egg and cheese biscuits. So what I have over here, I'm gonna scan you over, is bacon on a roasting pan, and this is actually a drip pan. You know, it's got, I don't know if you can see underneath there, it's got holes. And then that is a roaster, and that collects all my bacon grease for me. So, I put that in the oven too. That way there's no splattering, there's no spitting, I don't have to babysit it. Baking it makes it super crispy, so I love it. It just makes it easy. And both of these will go in the oven for at 375 degrees for about 20 minutes. You wanna keep an eye on your biscuits. Many recipes say to bake these at 350. For my oven, 350 is too low. They will end up sitting in there for an hour and they will be harder than a box of rocks. So adjust it the way your oven cooks. Everyone's oven is a bit different. You kind of learn your sweet spot after a while, but mine is 375 for these for about 20 minutes. Same goes with the bacon. So once these are done, I will come back and I'll show you the end product. All right. Be right back. All right, guys, just a quick end because my eggs are just about done. I really hate cooking in a stainless steel pan when you cook eggs. Just always, you always get this coating on the bottom. Drives me nuts. But anyway, all right, those are done. Here's my bacon. Nice and crispy, and I didn't get splattered once by grease. And here, and I hope you can see us because it's such a sunny morning, there are my biscuits. Here's my little biscuit tidbits. There's my biscuits. Let's see, I think you can see this without the sun being in the way. Is it focused enough? There we go. There we go. Well, let me see if I can turn down the light. Oh, there we go. There, now you can tell. Now, some of these got big and kind of fell over, but that's all right. That is all right. But you can see, basically all you have to do is just pull this right in the center and it will break apart in half for you. You won't even have to do anything. But look at that rise. See there? There's all our little tidbits. All our biscuits. Perfect for biscuits and honey. And personally, I'm going to put some of my pear butter on one. And yeah, so I'm gonna make the kids some sandwiches over here and get them fed because they're already itching to go outside. Daddy's just waking up. He was up all night with the baby who's having a hard time sleeping in his big boy bed. He's getting scared of the dark and everything else now, so there's the little monkey. There's the little monkey. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you give it a try, let me know what you think, and I will be seeing you guys later. Canning today, so be on the lookout for some canning videos. All right, bye guys.